Hello, Norway! It is William calling from wiwibloggs, and it is pouring in Ireland. Hello!
Hello!
Tonight we headed to the center of things, the center of Norway. Well, actually Oslo, but artists from the center of Norway. They were competing in semi-final 3 of Melodi Grand Prix 2020. 4 acts, just one winner, and she is Kristin Husøy. Shall we talk about her?
Let's do this!
Porig, I love that we are styled out like the Norwegian flag. Red on me, blue on you. And thanks to this gorgeous ring light, a lot of white light coming off of my shiny face. In any case, Kristin Husøy, pray for me. Look, she didn't need no prayers because it was pretty clear after all four had performed that she had the strongest live performance. The song mixes blues, maybe country, maybe a little bit of pop. It's all there. It's slightly generic, but at least the song has a point of view. A woman in a bad relationship, and she's staying in it. So that's why she needs your prayers. I think that she really sold it. I do want her to come a bit more alive, though. In the clapping segment where they zoom in, the backing vocalists are like, and she's just like...
Hey, for me. Pray for me.
I guess she has to focus on her voice.
It's definitely a song that is maybe not bang on trend, but quite on trend. It reminds me a good bit of the German singer Alice Merton. She had a song there about a year or two ago. And also a lot of people were pointing out Zibs, their song for Switzerland in 2018. And it was the same kind of raspy, smoky female vocals with kind of a soulful rock edge to it. And while it might not be the most unique thing that we've ever heard, it was definitely the standout thing there tonight, because when she came on, I was just like, this has to be the song that gets through. Because while she was maybe a bit lackluster in her clapping, the song, the beat, the vocals... they just lifted it up compared to the other songs, because the other songs were all a bit monotonous. Even the poppy ones, they were a bit beige. Even if they were singing about pink objects, they were a bit beige. And this, it stood out. It was like a breath of fresh air, really, which is ironic given how smoky it kind of had the feel of a smoky bar and that kind of... Like, even her suit, like, she was very sophisticated because she's only 18. Yeah. She wasn't your typical... Like, a lot of the times, the 18-year-old women on these shows can look very young and they nearly make them look too young. Like, if we think about in week one, there was... her name escapes me, but the woman who lost to Rayleigh, she was looking very teeny boppy and she was a similar age. Whereas,
Lisa Borud!
Yes, her. Whereas Kristin... looks that bit much older and mature, but it's a vibe that worked for her. And yeah, she was definitely the deserving qualifier.
Yeah, not the girl next door, the woman next door. I also liked how it started off in black and white, giving it a classic feel, and then our girl came to life technicolor. So let's go through the duels, actually. The first duel was between Alexandru, formerly of Sweet 16, with the song Pink Jacket, against Sie Gubba. Sie Gubba. They are celebrating their 25th anniversary together. They've been singing together since they were 15, so they are 40 and over. Look, Alexandru's song is plastic. This song was made of plastic. The pink jacket, I like the message, you know, he's like, I like a pink jacket, I'm gonna wear a pink jacket, discover your own style, great message, I think he's very charming, he looks very friendly, very likable, I just think the song, it just is a bit generic, and, it, you know, copy and paste what I said from my first reaction of the studio cuts, Sie Gubba... While this is definitely not my style, While this is definitely not something I would ever download, you know, they're a popular dance band. They're very well known among kind of small town... What am I trying to say? They're very well known. They have a very large fan base in small towns, people have said on our YouTube channel and in the comment section. And so I can see why their fans got behind them. Because to me, these were kind of on equal footing. Like, neither one stood out that much.
Yeah, well, see, the thing with Alexandru was that it was ironic for someone who's kind of singing about trying to break the mold and being unique with a pink jacket for, like, a masculine guy. He very much was your typical boy band material, and it wouldn't surprise anyone to know that he was in a boy band beforehand. And it was like a catchy enough song, but I think it just seemed catchier because the field tonight was lacking a catchy pop song. And if we had the likes of Rayleigh with her Wild, that pop was so much higher than of higher quality that this would have been swept away completely. But the main thing he had going for him was that he looked very well in his pink jacket. And then he had a big fan base because that's Sweet 16, I think, was the boy band that he was in. They were quite popular, and I think they nearly won this 2 or 3 years ago. But yeah, like, at the end of the day, looks aren't everything. But the group he was against, they're celebrating their 25th anniversary, but they sounded dated back in 1995. I'm sorry that it's nice, you can toe-tap along, but this dance band song, we've seen it done better, this dance band genre, we've seen it done better in other national selections, like Ardvinga, I think is how you pronounce it. They were in the Melody Festival in last year. And I think sometimes you're better just to embrace the retro camp nature of your genre and just celebrate the original sound. Instead of, I think they were kind of in an awkward space where they were trying to modernize and be kind of semi-relevant, but they weren't embracing the ridiculousness of dance band is what I'm basically trying to say. And they ended up just being kind of boring to people of a certain age group. They were probably liked. They were obviously liked enough to win their jewel, but
One second. So two final points here. One, Sie Gubba gave me some Albania vibes. I think the highlight of the song was when a man on an electric guitar kind of pulled an Aerosmith. It felt very throwback. And the lyric in Alexandru's song that stood out to me, he said something like, "I'm on a drug, don't know which kind." I don't know about drugs, but he certainly is on some whey protein because he was looking very swole, as the children would say. He was very much working the pink jacket fit, is what I'm trying to say. Mm. All right.
Just on his lyrics, not to be crude, but they were very masturbatory.
Oh.
Because there's all stuff like, "I'm feeling myself tonight." And like, if you read it in a certain way, it could be interpreted as being all about self-love.
Yes, quite cheeky. And I think after feeling himself, he said, "Hell yeah," which gave it that exclamation point at the end. Moving on, duel number two. Now, based on the studio cuts, I thought this was going to be the closer duel. I thought these two would actually make the final. Thomas and Erica with the song Vertigo. I'll be gone forever. The vocals just weren't there for me. I think Thomas sounded very nervous, and so the live performance did not live up to the studio cut. I think it's perhaps a more interesting song. It's just a bit weird. I just still don't understand the relationship between him and her. Is she like an angel? Is she someone who's dead? Is she a former lover singing from the grave? And throughout the whole song, they were separated. Red and blue, very Manuela. Like, they were deliberately separated, suggesting a chasm, distance. But all of that to be said, her performance was just better vocally. I think that, I'm talking about Kristin. Her performance was superior vocally, and it was clearly going to win this duel.
This song with Thomas was very confusing. Firstly, the fact that they didn't even give Erica on-screen credits, and she had to do a lot of heavy lifting. Granted, she wasn't the main vocalist, but still. And the whole staging, because she was there in red light, very much separated from him, as you pointed out. And Then on the other side, in blue light, was a whole pack of little children, like 5 or 6 10-year-olds. And they're all singing at him. And why are the children blue? Are they good? Is she the temptation that took him away? I don't know. And then the children, somebody clearly didn't tell them that this is kind of a sad song. You'll see them, you'll never see them again. Because they had big grins on their faces when they were like doing the harmonies that you'll be forever gone or something. And they looked thrilled that he'd be forever gone. And it just didn't gel. The song itself, it was a nice enough ballad, but the disconnect between the two performers, and it had a slightly dated feel that I'm not sorry to see it go.
Yes. So now we can turn our attention to the next pre-qualified artist for the final, Akuvi. And let me just keep it short. My winner of semifinal 3 was Akuvi. Now, she, of course, was only performing in exhibition. This was just to introduce the song because she is pre-qualified. I believe she is of Ghanaian descent. Her father is from Ghana, I believe. She absolutely brought some Afro-fusion pop sounds here. She mentioned this in her interview with wiwibloggs earlier in the week. Although the song appears upbeat when you listen, it actually is a dark song about a man doing her wrong and how she had put faith and trust in someone and was betrayed. And you get that anger in the live performance. The choreography, which I hear the word Renata bubbling away in your head, you can come to that. The choreography does have that anger, that thrust. I thought this was the most complete package we've seen, perhaps along with Ray Lee. You know, it just feels, from the first semifinal, it feels ready to go in many ways. Yeah, and she delivered vocally. I like that the song, it's upbeat, but it does have that tinge of darkness. I think this is a real contender at this point, based on the songs we've heard, to win in Norway. It's just a different flavor. It, you know, people will make the comparison, and I think Porg Muldoon will in a second, to All the Feels. But this has that dark edge, which All the Feels didn't have. All the Feels was much more upbeat, I think, happy, basically. Whereas this is like, you know, somebody did me wrong, and I was betrayed. I don't know, I just really like this. She sold it very, very well.
Yeah, well, I did get All the Feels when I heard it for the first time, and most definitely when I saw it on stage. And for people who mightn't been following, All the Feels was Renata Zentry and Melody Festival in 2018, and she got to the final. And it was a similar upbeat R&B pop number. And one thing that was very similar was that Renata was out front in the semi-final in a black kind of jumpsuit with orange streaks that looked nearly identical to what Akuva's dancers were wearing. And the dance moves, obviously, while it was different choreography, it was from the same neighborhood. And
the straps, like, there were straps.
I see, as people who are Eurovision freaks, basically, and we know all the ins and outs of us, we're kind of like, oh, we've seen them before. Maybe Norway hasn't. Maybe this is new to Norway. If you hadn't seen Renata, you would be very impressed. And even despite that, I still liked it. And I think out of all the pre-qualifiers we've seen so far, this is the most deserving song of that tag.
Definitely.
Because the rest of them, I think Didrik and his brother from last week got in based on their names. Their song was very old-fashioned. And then Sondre's was kind of very slick, but it didn't have a character to it. It was a bit soulless. Whereas Akuva's is very much
Akuvi.
We have the Renata. Akuvi, sorry. While it's the Renata comparisons or whatever, she still owns the song. It still makes you feel something. And she's fierce, she's independent.
Yeah.
And it's a good song. We need this kind of stuff in the final. And it's nice to see the native language in this style of song, because often in the likes of Melody Festival, it would be kind of the older acts that would be expected to be eliminated, bringing the native language. And usually the more hip and modern and current acts are all singing in English. So it's nice to see a current song sung in a native language and possibly in contention to do well in the final.
Yeah, this definitely feels the strongest of the automatic qualifiers, like, by far. I think the Didrik Soli Tangen, Emil Soli Tangen act, the staging was just abysmal. The song was tolerable for me. Clearly, you dislike it. Sondre, I was like, Robin Bengtsson 2.0, this feels very plastic. It's well performed, and it looks great, and it deserves to be in the final. Yeah, this is shaping up to be an interesting final. Wild, Rain Alexander's One Last Time, and Akuvi's song in Norwegian. All three of these, I have, you know, they tick different boxes for me. I think Rain Alexander is the most theatrical. I think Wild is the most commercial. I think that Akuvi's is perhaps, if I take a step back, the best, I don't know, choreographed, the best overall package. I just, oh my goodness, I can't wait to see how this turns out.
If only we didn't have to wait two more shows. Because I love Norway's effort, but it is a bit convoluted that they could have slashed several of these songs and had one or two semi-finals and gone straight to the final. But they're celebrating 50 years, and that's yay,
60.
good for them. 60! Wow, I
Yes.
knocked 10 off them.
So I think for me, I like the concept of just having four songs in a heat. It's much more digestible, much more like easier to follow. It's like you can get to know the artist more. Like obviously we don't speak Norwegian, but you get a sense of them in the postcards. I like the pace of this. I don't feel overwhelmed. I was actually making an aubergine moussaka throughout the program. It smells delicious, and I'm gonna tuck in after this video. Nadia Hussein, shout out to you. Bake Off Porig, the one from Bake Off. She's amazing. Thing. Love her. In any case, so I like the four per semi, but I think maybe arranging them geographically, I understand the concept of doing that because you want to involve the whole nation, give each part of the nation a moment to shine. You know, this kind of how Melodi Festival and goes around the country for that very reason. So I think for budgetary reasons, rather than going around the country, they were like keeping it in Oslo and they just bringing in the artists from the regions. I say just mix it up. Highlight the people from their regions in the show. Just be like, she is from the center of Norway. Like, do so, or film their postcards at home. Do you know what I'm saying? Showcase it that way because this semifinal just felt significantly weaker than the others. Like Alexandru appeared to be alone on stage. Musically, the songs were not as good. But I'm glad it's coming third after we've had two very strong weeks. The first week was great. The second week was pretty good. And now we've kind
The
of.
second week had two good songs in one duel, and they had two atrocious songs, and one of those atrocious songs made it to the final duel. So I wouldn't say that the second week was particularly strong, to be
Calling
blunt.
me
I'd say
out,
that
dang.
I would say that, see, if we'd had something along the case of instead of five heats with four songs, if we had four heats with five songs and
Yeah.
one from each region, it would have had the same effect. But anyways,
Yes, that's
we're
another good
not
way
the
to
people
spin
in
it.
MGP. Yeah.
I do hope they keep the semifinals around. Maybe, yeah, in some capacity, whether that's three, four. But it's amazing. Norway's a small country, and like, they're plenty, you know, the UK has never been able to stage a national final like this. So we should not be
No.
casting. I mean, yeah, this is like
Yeah.
clearly one of the strongest national finals overall when you look at production, value, excitement, etc. Norwegians are living it, they're loving it. I loved Kristin's sister in the audience. I always say this, but I think Norway has one of the warmer selections. Yes, it's competitive, but there's like a warmth around the whole thing. And that's not just because I've been gone a few times. It's like, it just has this really likable quality, and I love the fonts they use when they introduce the acts. In any
And
case.
even it has. Yeah, it has the audience. They have the few balloons and stuff in the audience because if you're looking at, say, the Lithuanian selection or the Albanian selection, they're kind of people who aren't living and breathing the
Yeah.
experience. They're just there to see a TV show and they're just very much like, well done, very well done. Whereas in Norway, they're cheering and all that. So that is contagious when you're watching the show.
Yeah, and when I was
So
in
well done to them on that.
Albania for Kunga Magik, it was a lot of like VIP types, and it was a great audience. They're really into it, but it was like, you know, corporate types, VIP types who aren't necessarily living the songs all year round. It's interesting. In any case, that's what we think. What do you? Wait a minute. Before we do that, Porig, I need your overall winner so far of all the songs you've heard thus far.
Oh, really? Really wild.
He's keeping it wild, wild. I think if I had to choose, for me, it is those three, Rain, Akuvi, and Raelee. I'd probably stick with Raelee at this point. I love that Miss Saigon opening. I love Tigress in the Savannah. But Akuvi, she is hot on her heels. And I have a feeling everyone is singing over their tracks. Like, I don't think everyone's singing. They're singing live, but like, there's clearly a lot of backing. Like, in Lisa Borid's act, at one point she wasn't moving her mouth, but the chorus was coming out. So I'll be curious if in the final we do get fully live. That will be very interesting. In any case, that's what we think. What do you think? Who was your winner in the third semifinal of Melodi Grand Prix 2020 in Norway? And who is your overall winner so far? Let us know here on wiwibloggs.
And make sure to subscribe, hit the like button, and turn on notifications.
Yeah, we'll see you later.
Bye. Bye.
Fantastisk Norge.